We live in rural Vermont, down the dirt road from a large dairy farm where two of my daughters work. Their jobs include the haying and driving the tractors and feeding the cows and working with the newborn calves. So we love animals, we have a great respect for animals, and we are very grateful to these animals for the sustenance they provide us. And Judaism has extensive laws regarding the treatment towards animals under the category of tsar balei chayim, which means that you can't cause suffering to living creatures. So we have laws that deal both with the way we treat animals while they're living and the care and concern we have with them when ritually slaughtered to provide kosher food. Animals cannot be hurt or abused in any way. Like humans, they must be given time to rest and cannot work on the Sabbath. An animal cannot be muzzled when working in the fields, and one must feed his animals before he feeds himself. That said, Jewish law and philosophy make it clear that there is a hierarchy and that humanity does rule over the animal world and can, with proper approach and treatment, utilize the animal for human needs, such as its milk or meat for food, its skin or fur for clothing, and even more so, holy objects, such as a Torah scroll or tefillin, must be made from animal skin. And when an animal is ritually slaughtered, the one who does it, who's known as a shochet, is supposed to learn Torah before the process, for it's considered a holy act both on behalf of the animal whose life is being taken and for the one taking the life. One must go to great lengths to ensure that the animal not suffer unnecessarily and that the killing of the animal be as quick and painless as possible. And I heard a really beautiful concept that this is why in Israel, traditionally, the big meal of the day is eaten at lunch. That's when people eat their meat and then they have a lighter dairy dinner. And it was explained to me that the reason for this is that if we're gonna take the life of an animal, we need to ensure that we use the strength and energy it gives us through its protein and its substance to do positive and productive things throughout the rest of the day. We shouldn't eat a huge, big steak and then head to sleep. Not only do we know it's not physically healthy, but ultimately it isn't respectful to the animal.